We last went to the moon in the late 70s, except for, of course, that rover that China sent 2 years ago. Still up there. Right now. Hey there, moon pies. Trace here for DNews. Apollo 11, 12, 14, 15, 16, and 17 all landed on the moon. Astronauts collected and returned 2,200 separate samples, totaling 382 kilograms. Three Soviet lunar missions also returned about 300 grams of lunar material, too. They get a participation award. While it may sound like it, that's not a lot of moon to study. That last Soviet mission was back in 1976. So when China landed on the moon in 2013, it should have been pretty huge news. The moon had been abandoned for almost 40 years. China's Chang’e 3 launched in 2013, making China the third country to land a wheeled vehicle on the moon's surface, and the first in the 21st century. The Chang’e 3 craft has a nuclear-powered lander and a small rover named Yutu, or Jade Rabbit. Yutu's complement is classified by China, but we know it has cameras, lunar-penetrating radar, which can look 400 meters below the surface, and two spectrometers for analyzing the lunar rocks and soil called regolith. I know what you're thinking. America did it first, China! You know what? You're right. We landed humans there first, and the USSR landed a rover, but there's so much more to learn about the moon. For example, Apollo only dug 3 meters into the lunar surface. It's not a lot. But in March of 2015, Chinese researchers published a paper in the journal Science announcing that Yutu's lunar-penetrating radar had found 9 subsurface layers on the moon. This suggests that geological activity had occurred on the moon since the Imbrian period, which ended 3.2 billion years ago. Lunar geologists believe that, quote, eruptions filled the basin where Yutu is sitting at least 5 times. Scientists didn't think the moon had been active at all in that period, so now more research is needed. For example, some scientists think the youngest volcanic flows may be only 1 billion years old, others think maybe 100 million, but really they have no idea, because they've never gotten to test them up close. Another study, published in December 2015's Nature Communication, used data from U2's instruments and announced the discovery of a whole new type of moon rock. The basalt rocks that U2 was exploring with her spectrometers are completely different from the samples brought back by the Apollo and Luna missions. Lunar geologists think that, one, this means there was explosive activity in the region, which counters a bunch of other theories, and two, that we still know almost nothing about the moon. As NASA put it, exploring the moon creates opportunities for international cooperation and economic expansion. Plus, it pushes the boundaries of our civilization. U2 is the latest in a long line of exploration of our solar system, and though mechanical problems rendered it immobile and crippled, the Chinese rover broke the record for the longest operating mission on the moon. And if you want to know more about the moon, make sure you check out this video on how the moon controls our tides. It's pretty cool.
Our moon has a slightly elliptical orbit that varies how far away it is by about 50,000 kilometers each month. When it's closest, or perigee, tides are more pronounced than when it's farthest at apogee.
Guys, what do you think about going to the moon? Would you go? Do you think we should keep visiting, or should we go somewhere else, like Mars or an asteroid? Let us know down in the comments and subscribe for more DNews every single day. Thanks for watching.